Have you ever wondered how React manages to update your screen efficiently without slowing down your app? To understand how it works, we need to start from the basics. A React component is a building block for your UI. It is fundamentally made up of two things: type, that specifies the type of element to be rendered; props, an object containing attributes and values passed to the components such as color and its children. This is JSX, a syntax extension in JavaScript used to describe UI components. During build time, a tool like Babel converts JSX to plain JavaScript by calling react.createComponent. To display an element on the page, we use the render function. This render function can also be converted to plain JavaScript by directly manipulating the DOM. However, direct DOM manipulation can be slow, especially if your DOM tree is massive, because the browser has to reflow and repaint the page each time a change is made. Reflow calculates the element positions, and repaint updates element appearances such as color. React uses virtual DOM to batch the changes to minimize reflows and repaints. The virtual DOM is a lightweight in-memory representation of the actual DOM using JavaScript objects. When a component state or props changes, React creates a new virtual DOM tree and compares it to the previous one, a process called reconciliation. It identifies the minimal set of changes needed to update the real DOM. Instead of rendering the entire DOM updates in one go, React breaks down rendering tasks into units of work, which can be paused, aborted, and reused to improve performance and responsiveness. It does this by using a data structure called fiber tree for the virtual DOM. Each fiber is a node in the tree that represents a part of the component hierarchy. Each node in the fiber tree has reference to its children, sibling, and parent. It uses a depth-first search approach, traversing from the root node as deep as possible before backtracking. The goal of this data structure is to be able to figure out the next unit of work as fast as possible. We've solved one thing, which is breaking down a big list of items into smaller chunks. But there is still another problem. What if while we're attempting to update the node, the browser interrupts the rendering before we finish? We would end up with an incomplete UI. React solves this by keeping track of two fiber trees, the previous tree before the update and the new tree for the incoming updates. It then compares the two trees to figure out what changes are needed and then commits those changes to the DOM. During the reconciliation process, three things can happen. 1. Previous and current element have the same type. In this case, we only need to update the properties. 2. Previous element has different type than the current. In this scenario, we would create a new node and delete the old one. And 3. Previous element exists but new element is null. In this case, we simply remove the old node. For list elements, React uses key to handle child reconciliation, ensuring minimal updates to the DOM by reusing existing nodes whenever possible. That's a quick dive into the internal workings of React. By leveraging virtual DOM, React ensures efficient updates and high performance. That's it for this video. As always, thank you so much for watching. Hope you learned something new today.